Yeah, that's fine. Thank you. Don't worry, Jim is coming. Hello. Today we have a somewhat unusual session. We have Gabriel online via Skype live. And Lisa here. Thank you, Lisa, for coming.
Thank you for having me.
And it's the first time in Jim's channeling career that he just forgot about the thing. But he's coming, we called, and he had to reschedule another spiritual meeting. But he becomes a celebrity, you know, very beginning of the celebrity career. But, you know, one thing that your schedule becomes packed. And another spiritual teacher, Barbara Carlton, our Reiki teacher, wanted to meet with him, so he had to reschedule, and he comes here in a few minutes. So I have about 10 minutes to do my introduction. And then Jim comes in, full of guilt and disturbance, because he forgot, and he's sort of, you know, he had to apologize and rush here. So his channeling might be a bit distorted with that, but otherwise we hope that he will come and channel. That's first announcement. Second, great thing happened. You might have noticed we have another invitation. So the whole site started from invitation by Yahyel and Yahyel Pleiadian Lyran Arcturian Alliance called Girk Fitneer to come to visit the colonies. And now we have another invitation, and 8 people, according to our channels, 8 people are being taken from the website to the colonies. None of them contacted me yet, but I believe the whole information is true. There is a lot of evidence, circumstantial evidence, you know, here and here confirmation that it all kind of comes to reality and manifests as true, largely true. Another invitation came a couple days ago through the Queen Aurea of a planet with secret name. We call it Utopia 5, just a temporary name. And they say it is in Andromeda Galaxy. And I looked it up. There is a huge galaxy with trillions of stars. So the address Andromeda Galaxy is like huge, but you know where it's on the sky. And it's populated with Pleiadians from Pleiades, tall Pleiadians. I suppose they're blue skin mostly, and some of them are green and some of them are white, mostly blue and white. And Earth humans, surprise, Earth humans live elsewhere, and so our genetics is elsewhere. They are fully genetically us, borrowed from the Earth, or enslaved from the Earth at the time of Roman Empire. And then they were liberated, or liberated themselves, as usual it goes in both directions, and now they are free citizens of this wonderful planet, Utopia 5. So I asked if they want our visits, and they cannot accommodate any immigrants because of their policies. They're kind of overpopulated, and they cannot accommodate us physically visiting just because it's not set up yet. It's the technology makes it possible, but not quite set up. So they will start working on technological aspect of that and legal aspect of that. For them to accept visitors from Earth would require certain permissions from different intergalactic regulatory bodies, how they call it. That's the second announcement. Third, a very interesting announcement is that I'm broke now. I just have money to go for maybe another week, and that's about it. So I need to get my income one way or another. And yesterday I was desperate, depressed, and scared at the same time. I was depressed first, but Angel Gahil, who visited me in the past, said that it is depression, it is just simple fear. You just don't realize, but it is fear. So I was fearful. Is it a good word? Mm-hmm. Full of fear. Now, overnight, it kind of transformed a little bit. So there are multiple, you know, it can be a problem, but also it can be treated as a challenge. And if you treat it as a challenge, you start solving it one way or another. So how do I solve this problem? Obviously, Jim is also in their financial situation, but surprise, his personal channelings are picking up, so he gets, I would say, maybe at least 50% of what he needs to stay afloat. He gets now from channel, personal channelings through you guys. So that is great news. So I don't know how much Jim needs per month, but I assume it would be around 1,200, a little more than 1,000, just to pay his rent and his food and the gas. So he probably gets maybe around $500 a month in channelings. So if he just get it a little more organized, he might start doing, and his health seems to be okay. He's not very much burdened by channeling. He could do maybe, someday he did 3 sessions. He could do possibly normally 2-3 sessions a day. And if the worry about money goes away and he doesn't run for any other source of income, he might get more free time. So personal channelings to gyms are invited. Now we are a little more set up, so you can write directly to him on the website. There is his email. You can communicate to him through Skype. You can directly, we set up his PayPal account. You can directly click on his private sessions. There is a button. You can pay for the thing. So it's not a burden on me anymore. So this is a great achievement. Although, you know, he needs me to do that, you know, videos. So a new flow of requests for private channelings would be coming. And for me to do these videos, I need some sort of way to stay afloat. Which is not that difficult to do the videos, but it's not more time, it's more like how much you think about it, how much you prepare for that, how much energy you put in that. And so far I have been putting like 90% of my energy was into that. And now I need to do something more down the earth, more mainstream. Zachariah is our new channeler. He has first channeling request to do that for money by one of our site members. And I don't know if he accepted it. He is a kid in school and with parents who worry about mainstream stuff. They're supporting that. They are supporting that, but not, no, I know. They also worry that he has to do well mainstream. And for a kid of 16 years old, it's a big thing whether you go mainstream path or you go alternative path. If you can, and he is a very talented channeler, he can channel easy, like much easier than Jim. The energies come through him much easier, so he's very talented at that. For him, it's not a big load to be channeling. He can do it with no effort. It's like speaking on telephone or even easier. So, if he can support himself by doing professional channeling, private sessions, then he doesn't have to go through this brainwashing through education. Hey Jim, I just started my introduction. It's kind of going slow, but thank you for coming through.
I'm so sorry.
Go get your tea and relax. I will be talking for another 10 minutes.
I'm so sorry.
No problem.
I don't know what happened. I totally, completely forgot. I had so many things on my mind, but...
It's a problem of being a celebrity. You know, that's what happens on television all the time. They have everything set up, and then a celebrity just forgets to come through and know what you do. You just put a commercial and another commercial. that sort of thing, hoping that, you know, they get through traffic or something. All right, so I was talking about Zacharias. So brainwashing, I say that education, I guess you have to understand the science and politics a little bit, but education is a brainwashing. You get brainwashed, you get into mainstream science, and you get master's degree or whatever, bachelor's, it's a little bit brainwashing, master's a bigger brainwashing, and then you get a PhD is a full brainwashing, and MD, doctor of medicine, it's a double brainwashing. When you talk to medical doctors, they're so brainwashed into mainstream, they can only think drugs and surgery. They, you know, for them to stir a step away and realize they are healers and they can heal with energies, they can heal with light and sound. For them, it's really difficult. So that is for Zachariah, and I was scared in my school class many years ago, 1977, you know, ancient time. There was a kid who just stopped going to school, and he was a starseed, I guess. He was a genius and very talented, and he realized it's brainwashing, he doesn't want to go through that. And I was so scared for him. You know, me and my friends came to him and said, you know, you're losing your career, you're going against the system will crush you. And only maybe 11 years later, when the whole system collapsed, the Soviet Union collapsed, I realized he was right. He could easily go without degree. If he's smart, not being brainwashed is a great thing. And there were a few other examples of that. So not going through mainstream career is a big decision. And I'm not pushing Zachariah to that, but you know, I would support him getting independent. Having, you know, I'm very jealous, you know, doctors have their patients coming and they are sort of free, after all this brainwashing, they are free from serving the system. I will give you your throne and then continue my introduction. Having some sort of, one of these whistleblowers, what's his name? I forgot. He is capable of speaking about things because he has income. He works as freelance video editor. Even Lisa is a freelance. When you're freelance and you have your customers, you're free from the system. Nobody can fire you. Fire. Nobody can fire you. I wish to have that sort of income. I mean, for Jim, he's close. You know, if he becomes a freelance channel doing personal sessions and can support himself, that's a solution. You are completely free. You are dependent on your customers, but your mind is there. You spend half of the, you know, of your awake time up there in a spirit world. That's, you know, that's very exciting. You know, being a Reiki healer would be great, but now we have so many in Rochester that there is not enough patients to do that for a living. So coming back to my career, I have that company which is a real one. It's registered LLC in New York State. We have a board of advisors, we have executives, my partners, who have their own means to support that, and they believe that the company might someday take over the world, basically. The market we are addressing is huge. It's, conservative estimate, it's $25 billion what is spent now on a drug which we are going to replace, which we are can possibly replace if we are successful. What is it? We are using extraterrestrial technologies, only very beginning of those, only the mainstream ones, but we are inspired. I'm inspired in by extraterrestrial technology, light and sound healing, and gene manipulation. And that's what I combine. That is, I have a patent submitted. It doesn't say extraterrestrials in the patent, but it says has light and genetics. It's light-inducible gene therapy. There are clinical trials on gene therapy done by others. There are clinical trials done on light therapy done by others. I combine the two. It makes perfect sense what I'm proposing. I have done some experiments and we have some preliminary data that it works. Now we just add the money, and even first $20,000 will push us for. I'm not asking for donations for that, but I'm looking for investors. Our videos are watched by hundreds of people, and each one of you has hundreds of acquaintances. So if you know investors who would be interested in that, I am giving a big part of the ownership of the company to the first investors. So they will get percent of equity. It's all set up, we are ready to roll. There is a lab which would rent me a lab bench, and they have all the equipment needed to continue the experiments. My previous experiments were funded by NIH, and it was over $300,000, which is behind my belt. I was a principal investigator on that. So I'm inviting contacts. Obviously, most of the people who are listening to me are not investors, but you might know investors. And the whole project we might start licensing the technology to others in about 3 years after about $3 million investment. So it's real stuff, but it takes some luck to start it. So that's one thing. Second thing, a job would be great. So I'm a molecular biologist. I can do molecular biology. I can do teaching. I can do travel. I'm also educated as engineer, chemical engineer. I can do technical support, being field engineer. I can travel and do either lectures, teach people the how to use the instruments or fix the instruments, that sort of thing. And I'm a writer also, so I can write things, and also a technical writer. So if you know someone who can hire me, that would help greatly. And Jim also would benefit from a job. We have been listened by hundreds of people, so we need help. We are desperate. We need help. And how can you combine, starting a company, doing channeling, and looking for a job? You can. Actually, you can combine the things. Any help in any of these directions would help moving all three of them. If I get a job, I would be able to do more channeling because I would have means to support myself, and I could support my company. So it's all moving. It's all getting there. But, now we're in trouble. So please think. If you can connect us to interested people. I know we have been already connected with one celebrity, one successful person, and maybe he could connect. Also, a movie project would be another great way to bring the money and do something very positive in the positive directions. All the directions make sense. Now, today, who we invite? We invite someone who can help us financially. So what we already asked this dude, I asked this dude many times in private sessions, please, please, please help us. We are desperate. And he helped us, but in indirect ways. But mostly Yahyel have very big trouble helping us financially. Every time I ask, next day I get a telephone call. And I'm very hopeful that somebody will call and help me, give a job or give me investment or give me an order for certain work. And this is every time would be a government contract mediator company which wants to give me a government contract, but I don't produce it. My company doesn't produce anything. And when we start discussing, we realize they have nothing to offer because they contact companies which produce something and give them government contracts. My company produces knowledge. We are doing development of therapy. There is no government contract for development of therapies. Yet. So that help by this dude was sort of missing every time. They're not very well qualified to help directly in that. They kind of inspire maybe some of the contractors to call us, but or contract recruiters to call us, but it just doesn't work. So we need someone else who would be able to help us find jobs in Rochester or elsewhere. I can move me and my family anywhere. We can do anything by internet. My wife is a molecular biologist, assistant professor. She feeds the family right now, but it's not enough. It is, even in Rochester, it's not enough. So we would move anywhere for, you know, if we can get some income. Find jobs or find investors. I believe there are investors who got their money from selling other companies or investing elsewhere who want to invest in something with the future. And my technology, combination of light therapy and gene therapy, is promising. Most of the application would be chronic immune disorders like arthritis, Crohn's disease, psoriasis, and also it would be very helpful with neurological and brain disorders. So applications are tremendous, and we don't have to wait for FDA to approve that. We would develop the technology and license even to other countries. Europe is much open to this technology. Israel is one of the most open countries to this kind of technology. So it's a real deal. So we invite extraterrestrials who could look from up there and find who can fund us and connect us. Because they are there, I know they are there, but you know they are blocked and we are blocked by lots of noise in the system, or advertisement and otherwise, and deception. So. One of those who is qualified is a spiritual entity L, who is involved in finances here. We invite him to speak to us. We spoke to him before and he responded to us, but that would be first time on camera. We are not asking for anything illegal or inappropriate or unethical. We want to be connected to people who need us. I want to be connected to people who want to hire me, who really need my expertise, or to investors who can... So that's very unusual, but I mean, you can use channeling even for mainstream things. You can. Lakesh Pale helped us in the past by consulting in business matters, and his advice was great. And second who we invite would be maybe hybrids who are already on the Earth. There are Pleiel. I would invite Pleiel to speak. Maybe they can help. They are already playing in the field. They are very knowledgeable. I think some of the Pleiadians, some of the humans up there also are very knowledgeable, and they can trace who to connect us with. We just need a hint, and we need a meeting. We will meet with them. We'll find LinkedIn is one of the tools to connect to those people. So if you know who to connect to, we'll get a connect. We'll get introduced and so on. We have something to offer, and that would be great help. And here I will play a little music, and then Jim, do you want to say anything? You good?
Sorry, I'm late. I cannot really tell you what happened because I don't know, but there was many things going on this morning, and I forgot all about that I had to be here, and I have another meeting coming up at noon, so. Very busy these days, just running around getting my bills taken care of.
Yes.
But, because today was the final day to pay one, so I had to go do that. So, I think that was first on my mind.
That's all right. That is expected.
Oh, not for me. I don't forget things like this,
you
but...
You had relaxed life until you became a celebrity.
I'm not a celebrity.
I mean, that's the first step. If you become channeler for...
But I do have a lot of friends who are, that I channel with now, and I appreciate your love and prayers. And everyone I talk to is really a wonderful, wonderful people. I'm really enjoying them as individuals. And they're all wonderful. By the way, Safira's computer died.
Oh.
Hey, Safira, nice to
meet you. Oh. You're back.
And Gabriela is still there.
I'm here.
Hey, hi.
I want to see you. I can't see you.
We'll send you the link, and you can see us in the recording. Gabriel, are you there? Hello. All right, we have Gabriel and Safira participating. All right, Jim, you have very little time.
I know, I don't have
hurry
much
time. Hurry to channel.
I don't know who's coming, but hopefully somebody will.
Oh, you cannot see? You're saying you could see. I thought you were pointing me by phone.
We can't see.
All right.
Now we can see.
Very good.
I'm still waiting.
You still can't see?
I can.
It's loading.
Oh. Greetings.
Greetings, how are you?
I am well.
Good.
And how are you?
Very good, thank you.
It is good to see you.
Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
Yes, nice to hear you.
Thank you. There is little time. There is much going on with your weather. Even at this time, the warble of the earth is causing great changes in the jet stream. As you have noticed, it's gone very far, far more south than it has gone in many years. Mm-hmm. Also, your counterpart, Europe, and the areas over there are having a very mild winter because you are taking the brunt of the cold spell. We are trying to fix the warble, but it may take even a year or two because of how quickly it's going and how slow we have to fix it to keep it within a safe balance.
Makes sense.
Therefore, we are working very hard on this problem, and I am here to just give you the information.
Thank
the
you.
Axis of the earth also is warbling, as you might be able to understand. When the earth is wobbling, the axis will also be different.
Mm-hmm.
However, it has not turned more, it is just warbling with the orbit.
Mm-hmm.
This has been caused by several things. Solar flares were one, but that is a very small part of it. There is energy from the galaxy that has since... Did you know that at one point within the last year, your planet was open to the center of the galaxy?
Oh, yeah.
We heard about that.
Yes. The energy that was drawn from the center of the galaxy to Earth, and Earth to the center of the galaxy, has caused a warble in the orbit.
Mm-hmm.
This is not uncommon, but not safe in all ways for mankind. However, we are keeping it as safe as we can. I thought you should be informed of this information. That energy from the center of the galaxy is now arriving.
Huh.
Because it takes light years to get here. But light years not light years to get here, but it travels light years, I should say. But it has now arrived. It's come very quickly.
Thank you for correction.
Yes, I sometimes cannot state it correctly in your language because there are misunderstandings of how things work within Jim's mind, and I use his vocabulary at times and phraseology.
That's okay.
But the correctness is that it is arriving now, and it's come from a long way.
Okay.
Let's put it that way.
Alright.
So this should continue to be a problem for as long as we can take to fix it. But it is very difficult to change the motion of an entire planet without causing much damage. So it is a very slow process. The warble must be done very slowly and with a very technical precision.
Mm-hmm.
As you might guess. Other than that, we are dealing with the outcomes of the warble as well. So there are much times when we are not available at this time. Mm-hmm. There is much of things to do. So we are doing them.
I
have come today because there has been a slight reprieve in the need for myself in putting information. Right now, they're doing more action than computation.
Mm-hmm.
The first stage has been computed, and they are taking action, and they have sent me here today to tell you what is happening.
It's a pleasure to speak to you.
The colonies also are well. The dimensions of Colony 1 are the most important, of course. With the telepathic children,
mm-hmm.
we're finding much innocence that is closer to what we can understand as basic human thought. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And with this basic human thought, we are able to communicate even greater with the adults, bringing the level of our communication up to a higher standard, knowing the basis of how they think now can bring a greater understanding of how the maturity of thought process in humanity occurs. So this way, we are now understanding humanity in a different way than we have in the many past years due to this development. And also, we can bring about telepathy much quicker in children because of our understanding of how maturity happens in human beings. This way, now we understand the centers of telepathy and the chakra unifications that happen when telepathy comes about.
Mm-hmm.
We are very pleased to say that quickly there are 3 more children that are telepathic, bringing our count to 11. This time in our history together, we are finding mutual bonds and emotions that we share and thoughts that we are able to bring together and unite ourselves in a bond that will not be finished even before the end of your evolution. I'm sorry, I probably did not state that correctly, but we will continue our bond with you, and it is stronger now.
Very good.
And this means very much to us, as it does to the Arcturians as well. The Arcturians have taken even a greater stance to protect Earth and humanity than it ever has before, and it wants to make sure that first contact is very effective, and they will not move until that effectiveness level is reached, because they do care about conflict of interests with the governments of your nations. We are now looking to make sure that life on your planet is preserved even greater, in greater force, because we can understand what actions might be taken by humanity during these times, knowing now how the development of humanity comes about and how thoughts are processed through the ages. We have children, adolescents, young adults, and mature adults, and even the elderly, in the process of learning how they have developed to where they are at this level, and it has been a very comprehensive time for us.
I understand.
It is very exciting for me to talk about. I am more excited about this than you can imagine, because we are now making real connections, yes, with Earthlings, whereas before we were making attempts at communication and attempts at real understanding, and now this is becoming reality for us. Very important in the process that we are developing. I know some may think out there that we are taking this information and using it in a negative way, but there are some that would, but we would not. We would not. I guarantee that for you. We only want to sustain your civilization. We only want to sustain those qualities that are high and in your culture, and those things that bring us closer together. We want those things to be sustained and long-lasting. So, now, the other part of the equations in the colonies. Colony 3, where we have visual, video, holographic projections being made daily, is coming along very well also. There's much hope now that they would understand each other better and be able to make features for your people that would be acceptable by all. This is coming around slowly, but so did telepathy. But in a matter of months, we are able to develop what we have learned and transfer it to all the other colonies in some way, form, or another.
Yes.
So we are moving closer to a united thought, a united feeling of peacefulness and understanding within our 2 cultures, 4 cultures, 10 cultures, how many ever there are to understand. Do you understand? I am here with much excitement today. Is there any questions about this you may want to ask?
Have the colonies accepted any more people from the website?
Yes. But I cannot tell you how many, because I am not privy to that information as of yet. But I was informed that there are more interviews going on and more acceptances happening because of this breakthrough.
I have an invitation from a queen, Aurea, from Utopia 5, Andromeda Galaxy.
Aurea. Queen Aurea. Yeah. What does she say?
She invited people to volunteer for astral visits to their planet.
Ah. This is acceptable. But I wonder if she realizes how many people would like to go. I think she thinks few, but there will be many. That is my only thought.
Are they nice?
They are acceptable, yes. They are not a dangerous race to you. They are inquisitive, curious, scientific.
How is it possible for them to be that far? So Pleiadians are in our galaxy and they are way far in Andromeda.
They do things differently than we do. They have thought projection abilities that we do not have. They also take technology and integrate it with organic much more successfully than we have.
So would you recommend for people on the other side to sign up for the astral visits, and would you think it's a good development?
The best part of that development would be to have humans understand even a different kind of species and see their culture and understand that they are far different but far the same as well. Does that make any sense?
Yes. They say they have many Earth humans on their planet.
From ancient times, they were taken as Romans and Assyrians and Greeks.
So they have humans there.
Yes.
Why can't you collaborate with them to learn more about humans?
We may be able to. Their communications with us have been better, have been rising. But we are not at the level of transference yet.
You're striving very hard to raise 11 telepathic humans. They have millions of humans on their planet, which are genetically us, and they're all telepathic and advanced.
I do not know that for sure.
They are.
Are you certain that they're all telepathic?
Certain more than 11.
Probably.
Yes, they are in larger extent telepathic, and they live in side by side with Pleiadians.
I do not think telepathy is exactly the same there as it is with us.
I understand.
Their telepathy is more and almost completely visual. Where our telepathy is also verbal and sometimes symbolic. We see symbols and not total images. We are not as advanced as they are in their telepathic processes, so their understanding of telepathy is different than ours, and it comes from different ways. Their chakra system is much more involved than ours. They have 39 chakras that they can deal with energy transfer.
Yes, they are higher dimensional than we are.
Yes.
But also they have great understanding of human politics, as Aurea said.
I do not know for sure, but I will check into that. I am so busy with what I am doing with the Earth, I do not check in with other cultures much.
It sounds like contact between whoever plans the contact and Aurea's people would be really beneficial for the open contact.
I will make that suggestion.
Are you open to speak to Saphir and Gabriel?
Briefly.
Saphir and Gabriel, are you interested in asking questions to Tekkrr?
I have a question.
Starfira. Yes.
Hello, Tekkrr.
Greetings.
Nice to... I can't see you, but it's nice to hear you.
Thank you.
I have a question. A reptilian came through the other day and said that there are negative attacks on the Earth that even those who are helping us do not know about, which makes me wonder if you and your and the Galactic Federation working for a planet, is there something sneaking past you, or was that not the truth?
We are aware of the technology. The reptilian that spoke through Jim is not aware of the kind of technology it was. So that is his explanation, but not ours. Our explanation would be that we do know what kind of technology they are using, but it is difficult to block it until they use it, because it cannot be found until the waves are released. When the waves are released, then we can block that. However, they released some waves during a very crucial time in our dealings with the weather and Axis, and they were able to get through, and we were not able to stop it within the first 30 minutes. So it lasted for 2 hours. But we were able, 2 hours and 5 minutes, but we were able to stop it after that point. However, some were affected. Many, many were affected. But it is stopped at this time.
What were the effects?
The effects are that you would be depressed, or that you would have thoughts other than what you would normally have of a discontented nature, or perhaps it would cause you to forget things altogether, or remember things that you shouldn't remember. These are the kinds of stimulus to the brain that they have.
I see.
I have another personal question, may I ask you?
Continue.
Thank you very much. Am I considered too old to go to the colonies?
No.
Okay, is there something blocking my ability to be telepathic, or any health issues preventing me from going?
I am not aware. I would have to check. Just a moment.
Thank you.
There is a question about cigarette smoking and lung capacities, and also which leads to heart conditions. These things would be a hindrance until further investigation to find that they have not affected the body in other ways.
Can they be healed?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Gabriel, are you there?
Thank you.
Yes.
Gabriel is not here. Sophia, we have one question. Oh, Gabriel, are you there?
Yeah. I'm wondering about the polar shifting. Will there be any polar shifting
in
the future?
Yes. We have mentioned before that the shift of the polar axis is 3 degrees, 3.172 degrees exactly, but we are keeping it in place. Even with the warble that we're now finding the Earth involved with, we have stopped the axis from turning. Several hundred thousand years, the Earth turns and the axis reverses, but we are stopping that at this time. We would like to preserve the society's
of humans that we are now in contact with, and it is a consensus within Girk Fitneer and other civilizations that you can be a benefit to the universe and galaxy if your race continues.
Gabriel?
Thank you for that.
Any more questions?
Thank you for the information about the weather. It has been very warm winter here in Sweden.
Yes. You are getting warm weather. This area where we watch is getting hostile cold weather, lower degrees. It's been below zero more times this winter than it has in many, many years. And this is due to the warble of the axis changing the jet stream into a very irregular pattern.
Gabriel, you had the questions about Yahyel and your personal experiences.
No, I don't have a question.
Okay. Safira?
Yes, I'm not sure if you're aware of my hybrid daughter. Apparently was an accident and she died in her hybrid body. Can you give me more information about that? Because I have some information from Lakesh, but I'm still feeling like I need to know more information.
I am sorry I cannot give you information at this time, but I will be able to speak of that further at a later time.
Okay, thank you. I also have an idea that I'm not sure if you're familiar on Earth. Sometimes when we have big meetings or workshop seminars, we have like spiritual parents who take care of the group. Spiritual level.
Yes, I have heard of your idea. I have heard your idea, yes. I know your idea, yes. Yes, I know your idea.
Is it?
It is being considered. It is acceptable to some and not to others, but it is being spoken about during actually the same committee that does interviews are also discussing this form of teaching and transferal of humanity.
Okay, thank you. And I would like to ask you, do I still have too much blockage around me to be interviewed? Am I still too afraid? Is there something blocking that?
I would have to check with the council.
Thank you,
Tekkrr. I must go at this time. Thank you for letting me speak. I am very happy to give you what I feel is very great news for your civilization. Hey.
Great job, Jim. Awesome.
Yeah, that's great.
Thank you. Was it good?
Yes. Yeah, it's really good. Really, really good.
Excellent.
Yes, it was awesome.
Cool. Good.
Thank you.
I'll watch it.
Talk between each other. I will see if Jim can get his lunch to go. And. You meet with Barbara at noon, right?
Yes, she pushed it back till noon, but she really wants to talk to me, so. I'm sorry that I was late, everybody. You know what? I totally forgot. Even Safira wrote me, see you online, and it didn't click. It didn't click. So.
We're just happy you're here.
Perfect. You arrived at the perfect moment.
Mm-hmm. And I was going, do I have a session with Safira today? And I better check my book. I said, I'm losing my mind a little bit. So, but anyway, yeah, because she even reminded me. She said, I'll see you online.
Didn't and I reminded you. I mean, that's okay.
It just went right out of my head. What?
I should have said, I'll see you at the webinar. That would have been better.
Yeah, and then I would have went, oh my God.
I guess that's okay. I mean,
it's all my fault.
It, maybe it was supposed to be like that.
I don't know, but it certainly was not my usual. I'm usually very on time, so.
Whatever.
But anyway, thank you for understanding. I appreciate that.
Next time I will remind you a few times.
Well, I'm getting my appointment book. I've stopped two different places to get an appointment book and couldn't find one I like. So I'm going to get one today. I have to have one because if I don't write everything down, it will be out, gone. So
I'm in this state for the last few years. You know, this,
yes, so.
Especially with children driving them around for their swimming and other things. It's important.
Well, I had a friend in from Buffalo last night. He left this morning at 8. I went to breakfast with my friend Tim. I went to pay my bill. And then you called on the way back to my car. And I was like, why? I freaked out. So,
so I invited somebody to help us with finances, and it didn't happen.
Oh.
How much per month do you need to stay afloat?
Need $2,000.
$2,000 is too much. How much did you get from China?
Not 2,000.
Per month.
It just started picking up. Before February, it was hardly anything, but now in February it's been like an average out of a little over 150, 200 a week.
150 a week makes 600.
Yep.
700 per month.
Mm-hmm.
So if you just, I think we lost a lot of personal requests because of these mismatches with Lakesh. He kind of gives someone certain percent of DNA, then he changed his mind and forgot about it and gave another percent of DNA, and then he didn't recognize the person who was a female, and I think a few people were very disappointed about that.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I hope Lakesh will come out and will kind of see some of his explanations were right to the point, so he did lots of miracles and then few mishaps happened.
Mm-hmm.
So he might need to calibrate his, his vision. He's way far from here, and somehow his channel becomes.
I'm wondering if he was affected by something, or I'm not sure.
Yeah, that sort of thing. I think maybe there is a law, universal law, that if you channel to Earth, you have to mix up 25% of disinformation or mistakes in your channeling. Otherwise, you will be blocked. That's my understanding. And somehow, different sources have different percent. I think Takeo, when she speaks, she is very careful. By the way, wobble, you say wobble, not warble.
Okay.
Huh. Because
well,
she used
a warble, too.
Warble? Are you sure?
Is warble a word, everybody?
I've heard it before.
Warble? I've heard of warble.
I think it's just
wobble.
Misspelling of
wobble and warble. I'm not sure.
When you read scientific,
what did Tekkrr say? Warble.
Yeah, in scientific text they write wobble, and warble might be just a slang.
Slang of it. Yeah,
people who never read. Yeah, remember warble.
I don't know. Huh? I've probably said warble and wobble both.
Yeah, she now is aware.
Okay.
I mean, that's not a big deal.
She
but when she said, when she used light years for time measurement, then she had to correct herself because light years is a distance measurement.
Yes.
And a distance from us to center of the galaxy to us would be like billions of years.
Yeah. What is she corrected light. It?
Yes. Yeah, so I don't know exactly, but it's certainly a very large number.
Yeah. But what about the middle of the galaxy?
From the middle to the galaxy, light goes to us very, very long time. I don't know what it is, but it's a very long time. So whatever happened, it has had to, if it goes to the speed of light, it had to start there long time ago to reach us now.
Right.
Unless it goes faster. So I want to go back to the idea of you know, I need money somehow, and I need help, guys. I need help, and girls, I need help. Jim needs help. I mean, if he gets his channelings just a little bit up, personal, he would be just fine.
Because last week was very good.
Yeah.
But the weeks, you know, it started in February to get a little better every week, and last week was very good. But this week doesn't.
What I need to know from you, people, what people get from personal channeling? Because every channel will be different.
They get verifications, I think.
But no, verifications. You know, until now it was Lakesh coming and saying, you have certain percent of DNA, you have that number of children. You're Pleiadian or Reptilian or Grey, and for people it's eye-opening. For me it was eye-opening. I didn't believe from the beginning, but when I get it from here and there, right now it's kind of a commonplace for me. But for them it is, it is a big deal. So that's what you get from your channel.
Well, a lot of people that I channel with want to know a lot of personal things about things that are happening with themselves, from what I understand from Lakesh and Tekkrr. And Tim Penn. They want to know why this is happening and that's happening. Tim Penn.
A new person, I never spoke to him.
He's a Yahyel.
Oh, yes, right. I never spoke to him. All right.
No, but he has spoken to somebody.
So what I ask in my channeling session, personal, obviously about my children.
Yeah. So, but a lot of people have outside forces coming to them.
Who has visited me then? And he looks it up and tells you.
Yeah. Right, and it usually, you know, they always verify that's exactly what happened. Usually, when I get done talking to them, they're telling me that, oh, this is what he told me, and that's what he told me, and.
Yeah, I'm very proactive. So when I speak to people, I start pushing my agenda no matter what, and it hurts the relationships. So when I have a meeting coming and ask Lakesh, so I'm meeting that guy, what should I say? And usually his answer is very typical, but you know, it varies from guy to guy or to a girl or to a woman. And like for one, it was, you have to first listen to him. Let him tell his story, and when you listen to him enough, he might open his mind to listen to you. That was his advice. It was perfect. So I connected, and I was receptive, and it was important. In another meeting, I said, "No, what should I offer him? Don't offer him anything. Let him offer what he can contribute." And it was another good advice. And for another thing, was a guy who wanted me to, you know, do some work on him. A friend of family work on his patent and promoted in the United States. And the answer of Lakesh was, is he paying you? And I said, no. So don't spend much time than you can afford. It was another great advice. So so Lakesh's advices were very, very useful in relationships. Mm. And in some other relationships also in the... And with family relationships and with some of the friends, with someone who is very sick and another one who is very sick. Sometimes they come and help. I get a lot of help with health from them. Take was great in advising me on diet and help. Take was incredible. They
didn't need to read anything today.
No, because you know Lakesh is not coming now. You have to leave.
I have to go. Yes.
You have to go.
But
back to Jim.
Yes.
I'd like to send you all love, blessings, and abundance.
Thank you.
Thank you for meeting today with me and with all of us, and I will see you soon.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Sophia.
Bye-bye, Gabriel. Sophia, you won't be able to see because you are using an instrument, possibly a tablet, with an outdated version of Skype, or the version of Skype which doesn't allow group calls. So only the computers with the latest version of Skype allow you to see in a group call. So make sure you're on the computer next time.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, God bless. Bye-bye.
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 I'm bye. Thank you. I can't believe
I got the information that in the future I might start talking with the tree spirits in the forest.
Oh, wonderful.
Uh-huh. I think
and work with that.
Oh, good.
But the consciousness of humanity is not ready yet for that.
But trees are wonderful. Trees are wonderful spirits.
All right, Gabriel is saying that he is about to talk to tree spirits. That was my interest for a long time. I'm very aligned with the trees, although I have allergies to them. So my relationship is double. You know, I killed a lot of trees in my life, you know, doing camping and stuff and building stuff. But also I work mostly, no, not young trees. I mostly work with the dead trees, but still I did some, you know, intrusions in the forest. But my understanding is that individual trees don't speak, not often. It's mostly you speak to the spirit of the whole forest. They have kind of united soul. But yes, I do Reiki on the trees. I come, hug them, I do Reiki. When I go, I spend time to put my hand on the tree and just meditate, uniting with the trees.
For all those that have people that are hyperactive, Lakesh said to go hug a tree and until you can feel its pulse. When you start feeling its pulse, it slows you down and makes you not so hyper. If you can last long enough to start feeling the pulse of the tree, it will calm your system down.
But I didn't mean the trees that I'm talking to. I'm talking with there is spirits and beings that are invisible to us that live in the forest.
Oh yes, definitely. Fairies and wood nymphs.
Will take stuff from some people just to play with the people. Then people go around the house trying to find that thing, and then in the end they find it.
We talked to a fairy once, and they are one of those spirits that are in the trees and near the trees and in the forests. The fairies, the wood nymphs, all kinds of, there's gnomes and things. So, yeah, there's all kinds of spirits in the woods, and they're wonderful. They really are. High energy creatures.
So. When I was a kid, I was told that I was channeling my Yahyel counterpart. So the tree spirits beings were talking to me, and I was channeling his response through me to them.
Oh.
So that's why they were excited about me. But then I forgot about that.
But they will remember that.
Yeah.
They never forget. You'll definitely be helpful in some way with your power.
Yes.
So that would be wonderful. I encourage you to seek that. Yeah.
But people will think weird if I take money on.
I know.
But people could connect.
Even my best friend doesn't believe that I can channel. So, but he's still my best friend because he loves me and knows me for who I am. But when I talk about channeling, he goes, okay, you know, he sort of doesn't want to talk about it. But the thing is about it is he does believe it, but he doesn't want to talk about it. So I think he does believe it. And I know that my best friend from Syracuse believes it. So
because I've always been a very psychic with him. So, but I never channeled until July of last year.
Wow.
So
you started in May.
Huh?
You started in May.
Not channeling.
Channeling in May.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I have recorded.
Has it been that long? Oh, my gosh.
10 months.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I'm sorry. I made a mistake.
Seasoned channeler.
I'm not a seasoned channeler.
We have another few minutes. Talk to me about jobs and funding for the company. How do I find a job or investor?
Me?
Yeah, talk to me.
How do you find a job or an investor?
Yes.
I don't know. I guess I would look at the companies that you would be interested in, that you think could help you, and then get in contact with them. But you know what? I would find out. I wouldn't go to the president first. I would go to somebody in the company and find out what they thought. Somebody like an employee and bounce your ideas off of them and see what they think, because they are they're more like the heart of the company. He's just the brain.
Uh-huh.
You want to talk to the heart first.
Uh-huh.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I don't know. They'll tell you where the brain's at.
Yeah, all those companies are outside of Rochester. How they get there?
Oh, I don't know. But if it was in Rochester, that's what I would do. All so, right. See, I would talk to somebody in the company. Or I'd go to the company and put in an application and talk to the person that's taking the applications.
Physically?
Yeah. But you know what? Lately, it's all online. Mm-hmm. So, they don't see the person anymore. They don't see the person anymore.
They do interviews eventually.
They do interviews, but only if they see you on paper what they are exactly looking for.
Uh-huh.
So, I know I used to do interviews, so it's very hard. But I took applications personally. I didn't do it online. So, I mean, I took some online, but I didn't. 90% of them were in person. So, I got to see the person, see how they were dressed, if they had tattoos on their face, if what was on there matched the person.
So tattoos were good or bad?
For me, it doesn't matter, but the company forbids them.
Forbids them.
So if they're visible, I have to go with the company rules. So.
I understand.
But for me, it doesn't matter. I wouldn't care. As long as I could do the job, it doesn't matter if they have tattoos or their hair in a bun or whatever. It doesn't matter. But some companies, for presentation's sake, do care about things that and how they're dressed. You know, if they come to an interview and their shirt's ripped and their pants are ripped, you have a feeling that they're really not there to be interviewed seriously.
Mm-hmm.
You feel like they're just there because I have to put it in an application. They're on unemployment or whatever, so. It does make a difference how your first impression is. However, I don't always just look at first impressions. If I want a second interview, I usually what I have found is there's something interesting in their makeup, in how they present themselves or what they say to you that makes a difference. So, and their excitement level and their joy level and if they have no joy at all, they're going to bring everybody down. They're going to walk in the room and everybody's going to go, oh no, it's him again. You know what I mean? But if they come in and they're pleasant and happy, that makes a difference.
Yeah, but I'm so so different, unfortunately.
Unfortunately, you're
so. I'm so, so, so different that it's really hard to fit in mainstream labs or in mainstream groups of people. Especially when they start talking about stuff. It's so depressing and uninteresting. And I already had the depression and discontent. So finding a group which is enlightened would be great.
Mm-hmm.
Other Pleiadians, other Starseeds who are thinking alike. And most of them are, as I am, are unemployed. But maybe there are some groups which are doing good stuff. How do you find them?
You got me.
Right. Know. Yeah. Jim and I would make a good team doing anything.
Yeah. We get along very well. We interact well together. Yeah.
Yeah. One project we could do is travel and give public sessions. Other projects. And we actually
didn't. I can do Reiki training.
You can combine that.
Not taught in the books. Some alien Reiki training that from Tekkrr.
Yeah.
Tekkrr did some very interesting Reiki training with me. So.
We should, but I don't see money coming. I mean, they can barely pay for the ticket. Where do we get? You need $2,000 a month. I need $2,000 a month. Where do we get this $4,000? The traveling with the sessions wouldn't support my family. No, it's more like it's barely paying for the ticket. Now, what else can we do? The movie project would be more interesting.
I gotta go.
Yes, you're right.
I gotta go though. But
thank you, Jim. We'll continue the discussion. Oksana has a lunch to go packed for you.
Oh. So a lunch to go.
Do you know where to drive? Do you have a GPS?
Yes, it's in my phone.
Yeah, it's...
I'll punch in her address and then it'll take me to her.
Yeah, 25-minute drive, but, you know, watch for stop signs. She is always 40 minutes late, so you're good.
Oh, okay. Good.
Yeah. All right. So, thank you for watching. If you don't want to listen about my project, then you can hang up now. But I wanted to talk about the technology which I have. And also about... rabbi, I went to my rabbi friend, a Jewish priest, and asked him specifically, how would I raise money for my company? Because that's what he's doing. He is raising money for his center, and yes, for his center, and he raised over $2 million for his center recently, a little less than a couple years. So he is kind of professional, and he's way younger than me, and he's very successful in what he's doing. So what he said was,
"It's good to see you.
Great to see you.
Love
you
nice too. To see you.
Love you both. Love you.
Good night.
Bye bye. Have a great day."
So what he said was that about 50% of his time he is raising money for his Jewish center, and it was great help. And really, if you are raising money, you have to do it almost full time. Yeah, 50% is a lot. And the main secret is you never come to anyone without introductions. So you need an introduction to a person. You need to find the right person who would really be interested in what you're asking for, basically to help, in this case was Jewish life, to help Jewish life and stuff, to promote Jewish values, which are also very good. It's a honorable purpose. And so you find through LinkedIn or through friends and through other ways to find a way to be introduced, even if it is fifth step introduction. Someone introduced to someone else, to someone else, to someone else, you need to be introduced. And then he says that the job is done. When you get to the right person, you get there, you end up with a donation. In my case, it would be more likely it would be investment, it's the key is to get to the right person. And it's mostly you have to travel. He travels outside of the town most of the time, and he travels anywhere and comes and does his speech and shows what they already achieved. And the advantage of his position is that he's kind of in the franchise. They did it for thousands of years. And even in his area of activity, he didn't start from scratch. They already kind of had a beginning, and he just develops whatever was built before him, so he can show real results, and people are impressed by what he can achieve with that little funding. And he achieves a lot, basically. That's a very vibrant, very happy community that he built. He is building, and the community is flourishing. There were many other advices, but that was, I guess, very, very useful. So in my technology, again, it's built on big past of experiments of others and of myself. So gene therapy is something which is the future of medicine. You know about genetically modified plants, and most of the agricultural plants in the United States are already genetically modified. They're genetically modified by evil guys with evil purposes. Basically, they put their genes resistance of to herbicides, and then they kill everything else with herbicides, but this modified plant survive. And not only they do that, they also kind of push away traditional plants. So the farmers that don't use genetically modified seeds, the plants will be also will be affected. So they spray things from airplanes and stuff of that sort. So basically, at some point, they push away normal life and create genetically modified substitution for that. So that is already a big practice. Bansante is the big name of that. You can research that. That's a big topic. I'm not very interested in that. But for humans, it is something that can save lives, make us healthier. Basically, you don't genetically modify a human to transfer this trend to the future generations. You genetically modify not the sexual cells, not the germline, but you modify the peripheral cells, you modify the other cells in the body which will not produce the offspring. So it's more localized. Is not spreading through the population. It is only for this specific individual. You can add genes which allow you to be more healthy or to fix the problem. Although genetic modification of humans is going full force, first by aliens, we have now Pleiadians through many generations. It's mostly historical through the last several centuries. Certain percent of Pleiadian, we have DNA, we have Yahyel, which is gray, we have Zeta grays, and now we know we have reptilian DNA monarchs and many other kinds which we will discover later. But we are a big mix. Obviously, historically, we are combined from Sirian DNA, Anunnaki, Elohim, Pleiadian, some sort of a gray, who am I missing? Lyran. I'm not sure. No, not sure. I don't think we have Arcturian, but we have a few others. These are major, but we are kind of mix of many, many others. But Pleiadian is one. Pleiadian, Sirian, gray are one of and obviously we have earthly ancestors. So in addition to all this alien, we have earthly DNA from which make us relatives to apes and primates and even mice. So we all have similar DNA to all our mammals, and even to we go farther. We belong to Earth in large part of our genome. So also humans, secret government and companies already do genetic manipulations. They modify DNA, so that it's not officially approved, but there are clones. Genetically improved offspring, so that is already a reality. And when you start researching that, it's a huge part of what is happening. It's not that difficult now. It's not that difficult. It is already part of the reality. We, you know, hybrids, not only alien-made hybrids, even human-made hybrids are walking among us. All right, so biotechnology, gene therapy technology. So gene therapy is in clinical trials. There are over 200 clinical trials funded by approved by United States, and even in Rochester there are 6 clinical trials, so we can go and volunteer to receive some sort of gene therapy injection and participate in a clinical trial. Most of them are for cancer. In China, clinical gene therapy has been approved for commercial use since 2004. So it's already 10 years as tens of thousands of patients underwent commercial gene therapy for cancer, against cancer. It's moderately efficient, but it certainly doesn't produce any weird effects. It's pretty trivial. We are genetically modified by viruses. Viruses come and go. There is a lot of viruses that make us sick. Flu, common flu, is a typical virus which is traveling between humans and carrying genetic information back and forth. Some of that genetic information is bad for you, and some of that is actually good for you. Our the whole genome of humanity is evolving, and new genes, if they are beneficial for humans, that transfer between humans using just by viruses, very naturally. Obviously, bad guys can distribute bad genes among humanity as well, and especially they would be interested in genes which would allow mind control and certain weapons. So if they distribute a gene which would allow them to turn off the enemy soldiers, that would be for them a typical project that would do. I don't know if it's how far does it go, but that's what very typical for modern genetic thinking, what could be done for mass control of enemies or even your own population. Here, so gene therapy right now uses very, and also there are nice viruses which live in our bodies, like AAV virus, adeno-associated virus, not adenovirus, but adeno-associated virus, which is, everybody has it, you have it, I have it, everyone, and it's never brings anything bad, it's just part of our system. We have bacteria living on our skin, which is healthy for you, for normal function. We have tons of bacteria, several kilograms of bacteria living normally in our gut, and even in each cell there is certain organelle which is called mitochondria, which is also foreign to our cells initially. So it's, you know, it's all mammals have it, all eukaryotes have it, but it is something foreign. It's not it has its own genome. It's kind of a parasite which became an integral part of our cells. So viruses in this way are also very normal to have for us. So there is a lot of nice viruses that sit and do their stuff in us. I can talk much more about that. Transposons is a part of that sort of integral part of our cell, which also jumps and multiplies. So our genome is fluid, and we know the main sequence of the genome, it's about 3 gigabases, about 3 gigabytes size of the sequence in each cell of us. And it's also fluid, it is, we exchange, and it changes with time, and it is modified by our life experience. Not the primary sequence, but the modifications of the DNA are modified. So gene therapy uses the viruses which are replication deficient. They don't multiply in you. They multiply them outside using artificial system, and then you inject in a person, and this virus is there, and it produces certain drugs, certain natural drug inside the body. So it's a great development for medicine, because it's a natural thing which comes to the cells. It's natural DNA which is there, and it's natural drug, the protein which is produced. So it can be very healthy, much healthier than modern drugs, which are chemicals which poison the body. So any chemical taken in amounts which are taken as drugs is toxic for the internal organs. So gene therapy is a fact of life, and it has been approved in China, Russia, Ukraine, and Europe right now. In the United States, they don't approve it for multiple reasons, and one of them is that it's once it's in the body, it's not possible to stop whatever it is doing. And many gene therapy drugs are there for months and years. So if you inject some DNA, if it's good for you, it's great. But if there is a side effect, you're screwed. You don't have a way to stop. Light therapy is also well established. When you travel on a plane, you can see in your booklets, in this advertisements journals, you can see many advertisements for light therapy for hair loss, which is working. Light therapy for obesity, which is working pretty well. Typically, it's red light and near infrared light, and light therapy for smoking cessation. It also works pretty well. The science behind it's pretty good. It's coincidentally, it started in large extent in Hungary and Russia, and much of the mechanistic work, the molecular mechanism for the light therapy has been studied in Russia, in Estonia. Actually, part of the Soviet Union was Estonian center, which did great work on that. So we know all the molecular mechanisms. So now my company, we develop sequences which are activated by light, and we insert them in gene therapy drugs. And now the drugs allow to be controlled from outside using a healthy LED array, which you can wrap around your sick organ, a joint, or put on your belly or on the spine, and activate the drug only temporarily using near infrared light. So now science fiction becomes much more real. So you can not only put the drug there and modify the genes, but you can also control it with near infrared light. So that is very realistic. We've done tons of experiments, and we need to do more. And we are raising money. We are inviting investors to invest in us. And for the first few tens of thousands, you will get certain percent. The investors will get certain percent of the ownership of the equity of the company. So it's all very realistic, and it's going to happen. If not me, somebody else will do that. But hopefully, it will be my company that will lead that. And we submitted a patent, and now I'm writing an extension on that patent. So it's all very real. So connect me to investors. Hundreds of people listen to us, and each of them has hundreds of contacts, so 100 by hundreds. So we are listened by, we can reach thousands of people. Hopefully among them there are investors who would be interested in that kind of technology. Obviously, it will revolutionize the medicine. It will eventually. The drugs will be replaced by gene manipulations and laser manipulations and sound manipulations. The field which is, it's now mainstream, it's called optogenetics. And where you combine optics and genetics, there is another field which is called optoacoustics, where you combine the sound and light and modify things. And again, it's pioneered by the military, optoacoustics, but it can be applied for health in a very positive way. So optoacoustic genetics, that's what we do. Optoacoustics plus optogenetics, that's what we do. And I need your help to connect me to investors. Obviously, any other help, like helping me find a job, even a remote job would be great, or a travel job, or I can be representative of a company and sell in northern United States, upstate New York. I can sell the goods of other company, be a representative, or be a tech support specialist, or do webinars and teach stuff, or do in-person seminars. So there is a lot of opportunities here. Connect me to the right guys, and I'm now actively looking, so I need your help, and I will help you. And we send you our love. Do you have anything to say?
I'm just still listening today.
All right. Gabriel, we are closing. Do you have anything to say?
I hope it worked out for you.
Thank you very much. And Gabriel is in, you said Sweden, right?
Yes.
And he's also looking for a job. What's your profession?
IT support.
IT support. So Gabriel is IT support specialist, a Starseed connected to Yahyel. If you know who might need an IT support specialist, do you want to reveal your town? Gabriel, do you want to reveal your town? It's up to you.
I don't know if I want to.
That's fine.
Travel with someone else.
That's fine. So Gabriel is also looking for a job.
And Jim is also actually looking for a job, but hopefully he can make his money by just having a nice time and enjoying channeling. I think that would be best. If I could channel, I would do just that. I would sit here and channel for you. All right, maybe that. Last time when Lisa was here, she felt like somebody wanted to come through her, so she might start channeling. And Zachariah is also channeling. He is great. So we invite also more channelers, and we'll be like a channeling hub. I mean, that's reality. We have it's like a communication station, right? All right. Much love to you. I will do a little music for closing. The power of the site having people and a community of people is amazing. I have another blog where I have 500 readers for it's for about over 12 years. That's a Russian blog, and the power of having friends who know me is amazing. They technical questions they answer, political questions. Just finding the person was easy. I am looking for such and such a friend, and la la la. I don't remember his last name, but you know, here's his photograph. Otherwise, I don't remember exactly. But in few, you know. Or right away, typically it's right away, but often in a few weeks somebody finds that person, and you know, or I know this person, but his telephone is not working. They connect me again. So the power of the community is incredible. So, and many people, many of you also need jobs. Let's come together and be a job hub for light workers. We need to come together and have our own tolerant societies. So Lisa, Jim, and I would create a company. Lisa has a freelance job; she doesn't need that. But if we had help starting, we know what to do next. Because when you get first money in, the thing starts breathing; it becomes alive. Right now, it's barely alive. But when it's breathing, it's easier to raise money for after that. Basically, for my company, I need about $3 million until we get the money in from selling stuff, from selling the technology. So help us to start, and we will do our best. All our intentions are good, and what I'm asking is proper, ethical, and rational. I even have approval from up there. What I'm doing is appropriate. And when you do your private channel session, don't be afraid to ask these questions. It's appropriate to do that. We are down here on Earth with a mission, and we need help in our mission. That's even Jesus said, don't be afraid to ask for help. And Bashar was saying, yeah, you don't have to force people to help you, but asking, you are entitled for a question. You can ask. It's appropriate to come and ask. You have to have faith in yourself and love yourself enough to understand you deserve to ask.